Hey guys, welcome to my channel. This is Trusty Rusty Depot. Today we're going to be going over how to install a shell. Now, a shell is what communicates with your computer to tell it what to do when you input a command into the terminal. In our case, it's Alacrity. Nushell is a shell that is built in Rust, and that's why we're going to use it. So the first thing you want to do is you want to open up Alacrity, so command space and type in Alacrity, enter, and then you want to type in brew install nushell. So once you've installed nushell with brew, you can run the command new to go into the shell, and as you can see, it's telling me welcome to nushell. And I can type help for more info. So there's a lot of information, and you can read the book. What we're going to do is we're going to set it up so that we can use all of the things we were using in our old shell. The default on macOS is called zsh. And to do that, we need to run a couple of commands. So we need to call config set path $nu.path. If we press enter, it set up the configuration file so that it takes in all the paths of our old shell so that it can find all of the tools we've installed. The next thing we want to do is run config set env, which stands for environment, $nu.env. And this is also doing the same thing, setting up the configuration file so that it can find all of the tools that we installed in the previous lessons. So the next thing we want to do is to check that it works. And to do that, we can run a simple command with brew, such as brew dash dash version. And you can see that it found the brew command, which means that we've installed nushell correctly. The next thing we want to do is set new as our default shell. And to do that, we need to find the path where nushell is. So we can type in which new. And you can see it gives us the path here, so we can just copy it here. And then we need to put it inside of the list of shells that we have. So we can cat, which means concat, it stands for, but what it does is it just prints out what's inside the file that we put as an argument, or more files than one. We can cat what we have inside of /etc/shells. And you can see that we have a list of shells here. And what we want to do is to add this to the end of this list so that we can put it as the default. To do that, we need to run sudo. Sudo is to have extra permissions because we can't edit this file without extra permissions. And then nvim, which is the editor, and then /etc/shells, enter. And it's going to ask you for your password, because to get extra permissions, it needs the computer administrator password. So now we are inside of nvim, and we can use J to go down, and then K key to go up, L to move the cursor to the right, and H to move the cursor to the left. We can go to the bottom of the file, press O to insert a new line afterward, and go into insert mode, which means we can type in this mode. And then we can just paste what we copied earlier. So Command V, and then we can press Escape to get out of insert mode. To save it and then to quit, we need to press colon, and then W for write, and Q for quit, and then we press Enter. So now it changed what was in that file. If we cat out the etc/shells file again, you can see that a new line was added at the bottom. Now, what we want to do is do this command called chsh, which stands for change shell. And then we can do dash s for the shell. And then we can paste the path that we copied. So the path to the new shell that we copied before. And then we can press enter and it'll ask for the password. And if we quit Alacrity and open it again, it's still in new shell. So that means we have set new shell as our default shell. The next thing we want to do is to set Starship as our prompt instead of this default one. So to do that, we need to run the command config set prompt and then open quote Starship prompt and then close quote. And if we reload Alacrity, you can see that now we have a new beautiful prompt, which is Starship. That's it. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.